what's the closest you can get within the rules? And the rules are, you're allowed to add numbers together, you're allowed to subtract numbers, you're allowed to multiply numbers, and you're allowed to divide numbers. You're allowed to have powers, but I'm actually not using those because when you're writing a program to do it, they explode. You get these ridiculously big values and it's just easier to not bother. But they are allowed, I'm just not gonna use them. And you're allowed to put brackets in to choose the order, so I'm gonna put some brackets there to symbolize that. And you're allowed to just bunch the numbers together. So if you look here.
There's a word that I learned it today,
concatenation. There you go, well done, there you go.
I learned that earlier today.
You're gonna have a concatenation themed day. In fact, you could take these two videos that involve concatenation and just play them one after the other. And so you didn't bat an eye when 3, 4, 5, 6, you're like, well, hang on, you didn't think, well, what's the mathematical operation you've done there to put them in order? You're just perfectly happy that, of course, 3, 4, 5, 6 can be there. And so concatenation's a strange one. There's no agreed symbol for concatenation. Some people use two lines. Some people use a plus in a circle. Some people use like little dashes or dots or all sorts of things. I tend to use the two lines. Right, to be complete, I probably should have put in this. Actually, if we go back to the past to fix previous errors, if I was being more thorough, I would have put 3, concatenate 4, concatenate 5, concatenate 6, and down here I should have done 4, concatenate 3, right? Okay. You know, to be more thorough. So that is, concatenation is clearly allowed, but we just, for some reason, we never bother spelling it out. So what I'm gonna do is, here's my almost but not good enough attempt. So.
Parker square.
It's not gonna be a Parker square, this is really cool. Right, so you start with 12, so 1, concatenate 2, so 12, then times 3, times 4, divide that by 5, multiply it by 6, multiply it by 7, add on 8, put that whole thing in brackets, and then multiply that by 9. Okay, so what does this equal? Well, let's check that.
It equals 10, 9, 5, 8, you've done it.
Exactly, if it equals 10, 9, 5, 8, we are on. So here we go. So 1, concatenate 2, that's 12, times 3, times 4, divide by 5 times 6 times 7 equals, okay, so that's the whole thing there, plus 8 equals 1,217.6 times 9 equals 10,958.4. Come on, that's not bad. 10,900, if you say classic Parker square, you're in so much trouble, Brady.
Classic Parker square.
Come on, that's not bad. Right, that's as close as I can get within the rules as initially I understood them.
Matt, in what world do you think I'm not putting a Parker square on the screen right now? Like a hashtag.
Thanks, okay, that is unnecessary, right? Okay, anyway, so as long as you're not trying to sell the t-shirt again, right. Do you know how many people show up to my shows wearing Parker Square t-shirts? Unbelievable.
Not enough.
Right, anyway, so what's interesting about the concatenation thing is it's never explicitly stated. So if you have a look at the start of the paper, he talks a lot about, he loves plus product potentiation, so powers and brackets, loves those. He will concede you can add in minus and division, which are like they're not as good as plus and multiplication or product, but they're okay and they're allowed in. He never explicitly says concatenation. All he does is in here, he goes, you can add A and B, multiply A and B, powers of A and B. Oh, and of course, A and B, forming a number. So all the ones in here, a lot of them do use concatenation. Right from the beginning, it's never assumed you can't do that. But it's never used as a step during the calculation. It's only used in a setup of the numbers that you then apply the other operations to. And I was like, that's a bit arbitrary. It should be a fully fledged function. If you're going to include it, you've got to include it. And so I found 1 times 2 concatenated with 3 plus in brackets 4 times 5 times 6. And then that, so 4 times 5, just so you know we're going with this, that's going to be 20 times 6 is 120. But then 120 is concatenated with 7. So now you do the calculation first, and then you concatenate with another digit. Then you add on an 8, and that whole thing you multiply by 9. Shall we check it? Let's just do this, simplify it. So that equals, okay, 1 times 23, that's just 23. I think we're all quite happy with that. plus, in brackets, that's going to be 4 times 5 is 20, times 6 is 120. Concatenate with 7. And then we're going to add on 8, and then we're going to multiply that by 9. So now we've got 23 plus 1, 2. If I want to do this all at once, actually, you know what, I'll do that step there. There's our concatenation, plus 8, and then that there's multiplied by 9. Okay, so let's should we chuck that into the calculator now? That feels like it's obvious enough that we can drive this home. 1207 plus 8 equals, unsurprisingly, 1215 times 9 equals that, plus the 23 at the top equals 10,958. There it is. So we have filled the gap. Because the gap was only there because people weren't taking concatenation seriously. And I've taken it seriously. I've filled the gap, and I'm going to send it in. I'll be like, I think I filled the gap. It is now available.
You know what? I'm going to give you that.
Really?
Yeah.
And the only reason I found this, by the way, is because I wasn't afraid to try something where the odds are I was going to fail miserably. And I think that is the moral of the Parker Square, right? You give it a go, even though it's probably not going to work, and you embrace it. You own it when it doesn't work. Every now and then, it does work out for you. Times that base. How do we work out the length of something? Well, you use a log, right? So it's log base, whatever the base is, of your next digit